suicidal, so you see the creep up in my coffin. I don't wanna do no talking. Can't you see the reaper? You go crazy, you go dumb. I'm gonna let my chopper drown. Now let's update the second virtual machine. As I told you before, workstation is dependent on gateway. First, let's install gateway because the workstation will only use the toy network that is given to it by the gateway virtual machine. Now gateway is on. Let's start the other one too, to give it network access. As before, open the terminal, write sudo apt-get update and sudo apt-get dist upgrade, enter. The password is change me as before. As you can see, it is connected to the Tor network because we opened the first virtual machine. If we didn't open the first virtual machine, the connection would have failed. Remember always, first open gateway virtual machines. When it is fully loaded, then open workstation virtual machine. This virtual machine is different than the other one. As you can see, there are many desktop applications such as developer mailing list, donate page, Bitcoin wallet if you use Bitcoin, GNU privacy assistant to make encrypted keys to use as PGP, password manager, ERC, messaging, another Bitcoin wallet, Onion Share to share files thanks on the Tor network, security instant messaging, image viewer, and Tor browser with better anonymization thanks to our two virtual machines. If a hacker will get our system, we'll only see the virtual machine and will not be able to access our host operating system. It will only see what is inside the virtual machines. If you are compromised, go into the virtual bot settings and delete the virtual machine. Follow this guide another time to create a new one. This project was created to provide a better alternative than using the Tor network on the operating system. According to the developers, you should use your main OS to go to the ClioNet, such as Firefox, and you should use only this virtual machine to access everything on the Tor network to provide you better anonymity through separation and differences between your Tor identity and your ClioNet identity. It also has VLC and the PDF viewer. It will has all the main application that a user will need. It is doing the latest updates. Now, sudo reboot to make the changes take effect. And now we are ready to access the Toy Network with improved security. Let's see if the toy project is working. It is. Here it notifies us that there is a little update. Let's do it. It is always better to check if your toy browser is fully updated before you use it, because thanks to updates, it may fix security flaws and security breaches. After the update, we will do another test to check the browser security, to check DNS security. Thanks to the website DNS leak, because with DNS leaks you may reveal your IP address. This means that hackers will be able to know your location. Let's wait a couple more time. Some people say that you should use the Toy Network to download torrents. Please don't do that. Never do that. This network is capped at 5-10 megabytes per second. It is quite slow, and you should only use it to access critical information, so to use anonymity online. If you use torrent, simply use a VPN to mask your IP address. It will be faster, more secure, and you won't steal precious bandwidth from the people that will need this browser, such as journalists or people that need in a nation with little freedom. And it's done. Let's go to the other website to check if we have any DNS leak. It says that we are in France, but I am not in France. This is really good. And the previous toy browser was saying that I am in the Netherlands. I am not in France, not in Netherlands. 2 layers of security is very, very good for privacy. And okay, guys, your Unix workstation is successfully installed. See you later to another time. Bye, guys.